Hi, this is Dave with EdgeStar Technical Support. Today we're going to be talking about the KC2000 single tap kegerator. We'll go over basic assembly, parts, instructions, installation, and maintenance. Okay, so we're ready to put our tower in. I just wanted to go over the parts real quick that you're going to need. And one of the things with installing the tower is that there's a sealing gasket between the tower and the fridge. This allows the cold to stay in the fridge and not escape past the tower. We want it to go up into the tower, of course, and it will to an extent, the cold will, but we don't want it escaping between the joint between the tower and the fridge itself. Now, with that being said, you're going to find two different gaskets in your kit. This hard plastic gasket will go right at the bottom of this tower, and I'll show you in a minute how that goes on. And there's a shot of our gasket. The other gasket, you may be asking, well, what's that for? Well, that's for a double tap tower, which you don't have since this is a single, and we typically wouldn't use this one. When we get into our presentation about the double tap kegerator, which we will do, we're going to use this gasket. So for now, we can set this one aside, and we're going to use the hard plastic one. You have your tap handle, red clamp, faucet tool, coupler, and faucet, and of course our tower. Now, you also might be asking, why is this bottle of soap sitting here? The answer to that question is, we have our keg washer, the little neoprene washer I was talking about earlier. This actually has to go into the liquid line coming out of the coupler. Now, it's very important that this gasket is set into the nut correctly so that it seals and also that you don't tear it. We've seen people tear these before, so I want to cover that to make sure that you don't have that happen to you. So we'll talk about the soap and its role here momentarily. So to begin, we're going to go ahead and drop our tower in. And the first thing that you need to do is make sure that we install our gasket. And by the way, it doesn't make any difference which side you use it. It doesn't matter. So we're just going to thread that on there, just like that. And we're going to set that up on the bottom of this. Now be mindful that when you get this down in there, that you try and center it as much as you can. It's not going to be 100%, but it'll be close enough, because you won't be able to see it once you get the tower on there. So we're going to drop our line in first, and then, and by the way, again, these have flanges, so you'll match up the open flange inside with what's here at the bottom of the tower. Now remember I told you about your gasket. So, and by the way, I'm not going to do it here, but you can actually put a piece of tape on this trim ring so that it doesn't slide up and down and potentially scratch the tower. If you're careful with it, you shouldn't have a problem with it. So what we're going to do, again, just make sure your gasket's kind of centered. Drop it down. And half a turn. And you can set your trim ring back down. And that's all you need to lock the tower in place. So the next thing we're going to do here is we're going to go ahead and install our faucet. And I'll show you how that's done and get our tap on there, our tap handle here. So next thing we do is we pick up our faucet. Now, this has a bit of a give to it. And if you'll notice around the outer edge, there are little holes every so often on this nut. You're going to take your tool and you're going to hook the pointy end here into one of these holes, and that gives you a way to tighten it up. Now I'm going to advise you that you don't over tighten it. There's a reason for that. If we over tighten it, this is plastic here. This tower is stainless, but the trim piece here for this is plastic. If you over tighten this, you'll crack and crush this piece, and we're in big trouble. So you need to make sure that, number one, your rubber gasket is in here where it should be pre-installed. We're going to get this up in there, and we're going to start this with our fingers. And by the way, this is a counterclockwise thread. You have to tighten it up as much as you can with your hand, just like I did there. Take your tool, hook it in, and tighten until it's firmly snug. No more. All right. Once that's done, we're going to thread our handle on. And that's pretty much it for the tower. Now, we're going to move on to our coupler here. Now, the coupler has a blue cap that covers the top threaded section here. We're going to just kind of pop that off. And then what we're going to do is we're going to reach down in here. We're going to grab our tower line, the one with the nut that's already pre-attached. And what we're going to do is we're going to grab our bottle of dish soap. And here's where the magic happens. So what you're going to do, little tiny drop. That's all you need. You're going to lube up both sides of it. Then we're going to come in here. And you're going to take your two fingers, your thumb and index, and you're going to push that nut all the way up against the end of the hose. Then you're just going to seat this in there. And you're going to work it around until it's all the way down. Then what you're going to do, your coupler threads on there like that. And you can make sure it's tight. Now you can use, again, you can use an open end wrench, adjustable wrench. Snug this up just a hair until it's snug and it's tight. You don't want to over tighten it because you'll pull the crimp out here. And that part is done. Then what you're going to do, you're going to go back in here and you're going to grab your gas line. Remember, this goes through the back of the kegerator. Slide your clamp on. Don't let it slide back in there, otherwise you're digging for it. This end is for your gas. And you're going to want to work this down in there. And you're going to bottom it out. And then once you do that, just like we did on that gas line on the back, you heard a click. So that's our sign that our clamp is getting tight. And again, you're going to take a pair of pliers and squeeze that shut some more until you can't squeeze it anymore. All right, one of the last few steps here that we have with just final assembly is our drip rail. These have just these little rubber legs and they're just going to push down in there. Don't beat on it real hard or anything, because see, just like I'm doing, just going to hit it a little bit. They're not going to seat all the way down. That's okay, don't worry about it. That's on. And then of course we have our little drip tray. Now the drip tray comes apart into two pieces. There we go. So these are all washable. You're going to want to wash this. You're going to get beer in there. It's going to get funky if you don't. So make sure you wash it. Just hand wash it. You don't need to put it in the dishwasher. It probably doesn't do it any good. So once we get that in there, that sets right there. It's got these little rubber feet, keeps it from sliding around. That's pretty well it on final assembly.